Hey, it's Lego Jang here with another Faceless One mock in my Faceless One series. All the characters in this series are based on the same torso, the same basic build. They just have different details added onto them, very much like the regular official heroes. This series is basically like anti-heroes. The very first video that I did of Faceless Ones gave a little bit of backstory for them. So if you want the backstory, you can go back to see the first one, which was the red one, I believe, if I remember correctly. And this right here, I think, is going to be my last in this series, just because I've kind of gotten tired of the theme, and I want to have more parts available at all times for other mocks to be made. So this one obviously just goes with the color scheme that uses white with the orange accent. This guy has a shield. You can see he doesn't stand up very well on the brick background, base plate background. I'm using the gray because he's got white parts. They don't show up against a white background, but on a normal surface, he actually stands up okay. He's got a shield with spikes, a very large spike area on the front of it, so you can actually use that to do a, you know, kind of a shield bash with it. Also, this part right here that spins is supposed to indicate kind of a dark energy mesh that when it spins up fully, it can actually expand out, so it'd create a larger disc of just dark energy, which would absorb or deflect incoming shots. That makes him almost invulnerable directly from the front. He gets a little bit of kinetic impact from shots coming in, but energy doesn't come through towards him when that's spun up. The weakness of it is that it has to be spun up for it to be fully open. Otherwise, he just has this small little area, which probably isn't going to be that effective against any sort of ranged weapon. You know, it's useful against any melee attacks, but he's not a particularly fast character. He's kind of a gladiator type of character because he does have a melee weapon. And I had come up with a name for this, but I have forgotten what the name was. It's the hammer itself was called the Hand of insert name here, and I don't remember what the name was. That's weak, but oh well. I'm doing the video anyway. The hand of some fallen foe of his, and he calls it that because, well, first, it's a dramatic name, and secondly, it actually has the hand of one of his fallen foes attached to the bottom of it as sort of a trophy-like decoration. So yeah, just a good old hammer there. Goes with his color scheme, but this one does have a ranged attack option also, unlike most hammers. This one can actually open up in the front like so, and when that happens, then he can shoot with it. So I don't know if it would actually be a single blast as much as more of a short beam. So I think this would actually let out a beam of energy based on its design. I think that would be a better idea than little pistol, like, you know, laser pistol, plasma gun type blasts. So not a continuous beam where he can just, you know, cut a whole swath through a whole battalion of enemies or something, but, you know, something that would last and have a continuous stream of energy coming out for, I don't know, second or two, something like that. So he could cut something with it, but can't take on too many different enemies with it. So just a few options that he has there, kind of in his backstory for explaining some of his combat capabilities, both offensive and defensive. And yeah, I think that just about does it for this one. Not all that happy with this one overall. I originally started out doing a blue character, and then that just seemed too obvious to me to just do another primary color. I like to to kind of break the mold and do some different things. So I went to a different color scheme, kind of picking a little bit from Nex, his color scheme, not intentionally, but I wanted to go to white. I was going to try to do white and black and that's it. But then I needed to put a hero core in here, an inactive hero core, and I needed to choose a color, and the thing that came to mind first was orange, probably because it's the exact opposite of blue on the color wheel, and blue was the color that I was working with, so I was trying to get away from that as much as possible. I also didn't want it to look like Stormer at all, Stormer using the blue hero core. So from there, the rest just kind of fell into place as far as the color scheme is concerned. And I did want to do one with a melee style weapon, and hammer just came to my head very quickly, and I started working from there. And that's it. I do believe this will be my last Faceless One mock. If I come up with another bit of inspiration quickly, very, very quickly after this video is being taped, not after it's being published. It's published much later than when it's taped or, recorded. I may do another one, but that inspiration won't have very long to sneak in, because I'm going to start taking this apart pretty soon, because I've got too many mocks now and I need to move along. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you next time.